ओके, आई एम रश्मि कुमारी गुप्ता, सीनियर साइंटिफिक ऑफिसर, स्टेट फॉरेंसिक साइंस लैबोरेटरी, राजस्थान, जयपुर. माय टॉपिक इज सोडियम थायोसल्फेट, अ नोबल सब्सटेंस मिसयूज्ड इन मनी स्कैम्स. मनी स्कैम्स आर वेरी कॉमन नाउअडेज एंड क्रिमिनल्स आर कमिंग एवरी डे विद न्यू ट्रिक्स टू मेक मनी एंड चीट इनोसेंट्स बाय क्रिएटिंग ए माइंडसेट इन फ्रंट ऑफ देम बाय यूजिंग डिफरेंट केमिकल्स. वन सच काइंड ऑफ स्कैम इज ब्लैक मनी स्कैम. नेक्स्ट स्लाइड मैम, प्लीज. नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. इन दिस स्कैम द स्कैमर क्लेम दैट दे हैव डाइड द मनी टू अवॉइड डिटेक्शन बाय कस्टम ऑफिशियल्स, बट द केमिकल टू रिमूव द डाई आर टू एक्सपेंसिव एंड इफ समवन पुट अप द मनी फॉर द एक्सपेंसिव केमिकल दे वुड गिव हिम अ कट. नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. स्कैमर ऑफर टू गिव अ डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन बाय क्लीनिंग द ऑलरेडी डाइड रियल करेंसी नोट्स विद द केमिकल विच दे कॉल मैजिक क्लीनिंग सोल्यूशन and prove that all of the bills are real, while rest of the bundle are actually black paper cut in the same size. Chemicals used in this money scam are generally iodine solution, which is used to dye the notes, and crushed vitamin C tablets having ascorbic acid to remove the dye. Next slide, ma'am. So many cases are received in our laboratory for chemical examination. One of such case was received in our ma'am, I'm audible? Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, you are audible, please.
Yeah.
Please. So many cases
are getting the voice.
Okay, sir, thank you. So many cases are received in our laboratory for chemical examination. One such type of case was received in our lab, in which two samples were received marked C and E for chemical examination, which were recovered from the con men, which were doing this black money scam. On observation, physically, the sample marked C was found liquid, dark brown in color, miscible in water and having tincture iodine like smell. The sample marked E was found solid, off white in color, sparingly soluble in water and having no specific odor. On the observation and previously available literature, the sample marked C was expected to be an iodine solution and the sample marked E was suspected as an ascorbic acid. Next slide, ma'am. Further, some color tests were performed. Iodine starch test, iodoform test, and few more tests confirmed the sample C to be an iodine solution. Now, we tested sample E with methylene blue and phthalein reagent. Surprisingly, both tests were found negative for ascorbic acid. Now, we tested the sample for calcium hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide, which are also used in this type of money scam, but all were found negative. Now, this was the challenging task for us to identify the unknown chemical without any advanced technique. Interestingly, while we were doing color test for ascorbic acid and the sample was treated with AgNO3 silver nitrate, instead of getting silver gray metallic PPT, the sample changed to yellow, orange, brown, and finally black in color, which reminded me of one of the cases which I had done earlier for sodium thiosulfate, which was received in our lab as SMEC. Next slide, ma'am. Further, some color tests confirmed this suspicion of sodium thiosulfate. Now, the sample marked C and E were tested to dye the paper or to removing the dye. The sample marked C was when sample marked C was spotted on the paper, it blackened the paper, so it can be used as a dyeing reagent. And the sample marked E, along with controlled sodium thiosulfate, removed the dye. Next slide, ma'am. For further confirmation, TLC was done. Sample was spotted on TLC plate along with the sodium thiosulfate. Plate was done in the solvent system, ethyl acetate, acetic acid ratio, formic acid water in the ratio of 6:1:1:2. After the run, plate was observed under UV light 254 nm and 366 nm. In both the lights, the sample did not give any spot corresponding to the ascorbic acid, controlled ascorbic acid, while in 254 nm, the sample gave a spot corresponding to the sodium thiosulfate. Next slide. UV spectra was recorded for the sample E along with the controlled sodium thiosulfate in distilled water solution. The spectra was recorded at lambda max was recorded at 216 nm for the sample as well as for the sodium thiosulfate, which confirmed the sample to be sodium thiosulfate. Next slide. Results showed that in this scam, iodine solution was used to dye the notes and sodium thiosulfate was used to remove the dye. Next slide. Scammers are coming every day with new chemicals to cheat innocents. So this becomes a challenging task to identify a new chemical. This time also criminals used different chemicals, sodium thiosulfate instead of ascorbic acid for cheating the innocents due to its similar properties and wide availability. Sodium thiosulfate is a widely available substance as well as it is 10 times cheaper than ascorbic acid. So it's a better choice for the scammers. It is one of its kind and a new methodology where our working experience made us to identify the unknown chemical by TLC chemical methods and UV spectroscopy technique. This study will give new insights to forensic scientists. These are the references. Next slide. I am very grateful to Dr. Ajay Sharma sir, Director, State Forensic Science Laboratory for facilitating this work. Dr. Rakhi Khanna, ma'am, additional director for her constant encouragement and assistant director's chemistry for their guidance. I also thank my family, friends, and colleagues. Thank you.